Good morning, Groundbreakers, and welcome to our Groundbreakers session this morning. This week we are continuing with our Storytime with Jesus theme, and the big idea this week is the prodigal son. And the big point that we want you to get out of the session today is that God welcomes lost people home. So let's pray before we start the session today. Dear God, we thank you for everything that we're going to learn today from your word. Lord, we thank you for the story of the prodigal son, and we pray that you would speak to us through this story today. Lord, we thank you that you welcome lost people home, Lord. We thank you that you forgive us and that you love us. In Jesus' name, and everybody said, Amen. We are now going to have our story time, and the story today is about the prodigal son, and I'm reading from the Storybook Bible, and it's entitled Running Away. Maybe you can see if you can go and grab a blanket and some cushions and snuggle up ready to listen to the story this morning. Jesus told this story about a boy who ran away. Once upon a time, there was a boy and his dad. Now, one day the boy gets to thinking. Can you give me a thinking face? Maybe if I didn't have my dad around telling me what is good for me all the time, I'd be happier. He's spoiling my fun, he thinks. Does my dad really want me to be happy? Does my dad really love me? The son never thought of that before, but suddenly he doesn't know anymore. So then the son goes to his father and says, Dad, I'm better off without you. I can look after myself. Just give me my share of your money. His father is sad, but he won't force his boy to stay. So he gives his son what he wants. The son takes the money and goes on a long, long journey to a far-off country. And everything is wonderful and perfect for a while. He can go wherever he wants, do whatever he wants, be whoever he wants. He is the boss and he is free. Sometimes he gets a strange, hungry, homesick feeling inside his heart. But then he just eats more, or drinks more, or buys more clothes, or goes to more parties until it goes away. But soon his money runs out. And so do his friends. He ends up getting the only job he can find, feeding the pigs. Ooh, what a horrible job. One day, he is so hungry. Can you rub your tummy like you're really hungry? And he's so desperate, he even tries to eat the pig's food. Ooh, that must be horrible. What am I doing? He says suddenly, as if he has woken up from a nightmare. He spits, yuck, all of it, ick, out of his mouth. My father is rich, and here I am in a pigsty eating piggy food. He wipes his mouth, see if you can wipe your mouth, and dusts himself off, because he's all dirty from the pigs. I'm going home. As he starts for home, he begins to worry. Dad won't love me anymore. I've been too bad. He won't want me for his son anymore. So he practices his I'm sorry speech. All this time, what he doesn't know is that day after day, his dad has been standing on his porch, straining his eyes, looking into the distance, waiting for his son to come home. He just can't stop loving him. He longs for the sound of his boy's voice. He cannot be happy until he gets him back. The sun is still a long way off, but his dad sees him coming. What will the dad do? Fold his arms and frown? Shout, "That'll teach you!" And, "Just you wait, young man!" No, that's not how the story goes. The dad leaps off the porch, races down the hill, through the gap in the hedge, up the road, before his son can even begin to say, "I'm sorry." His dad runs to him, throws his arms around him and can't stop kissing him. "Let's have a party," his dad shouts. "My boy's home. He ran away. I lost him, but now I have him back." Jesus told them, God is like the dad who couldn't stop loving his boy. And people are like the son who said, "Does my dad really want me to be happy?" Jesus told people this story to show them what God is like and to show people what they are like so they could know, however far they ran, however well they did, however lost they were, it wouldn't matter. Because God's children could never run too far or be too lost for God to find them. What a wonderful story of how special we are and how loved we are by God.
Memory verse for today is from Luke chapter 15, verse 20, and it goes like this. So he got up and went to his father. But when he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion. He ran to his son, threw his arms round him and kissed him. Luke 15, verse 20. I wonder if you've got any Lego figures in your house or other sorts of figures or dolls. How about you try and act out this memory verse in order to learn it? I've got these two Lego men here, the son and the father. So let's do the verse. So he got up and went to his father, but while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion. He ran to his son, threw his arms round him, and kissed him. If you don't have any Lego figures, or if you'd rather, you could try and act this out with maybe a sister or a brother or your parents. Let's do the memory verse again to try and learn it. So he got up and went to his father, but when he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion. He ran to his son, threw his arms round him and kissed him. Luke chapter 15, verse 20.
Is it possible to do so many bad things that God would turn you away? I once upset my school friend so badly that when I went to him and said, "Look, I'm really sorry," he said, "No, I won't forgive you." And he turned me away. The son in the story that we've heard today, Jesus' parable, he did a terrible thing. He said, "I wish you were dead." He didn't say it with his mouth. He said it with his actions. He wanted his inheritance. That was something nobody ever asked their dad for. Why? Because it was the very things that you would only get once your dad had died. So to ask for it was doing that very thing. It was saying, I wish you were dead. And then he turned his back and said another thing by his actions. As he walked off to live his life his own way, he said, I'm better off without you. Isn't that shocking? I'm better off without you. It wasn't true, of course, and he learnt that all too quickly. He needed his dad so badly. And once he finally realised and turned to go back, he started to wonder, will he really accept me? Do you ever wonder if God will accept you? Especially after some of the ways that you treat him. He shouldn't, of course. He shouldn't accept any of us. We treat God in terrible ways. Every time we say, I want to do this, no matter what. This is what I want. We put ourselves first. It's like playing that game, King of the Castle. Have you ever played it? It would be like standing on this bench and pushing everyone else down and then fighting with each other, and whoever ends up standing on the bench in the end can cry, I'm the king of the castle. You're the dirty rascal. I used to love that game when I was a kid. Well, we play that game with God all the time. Every time we say to him, I want to do this my way, we say, I'm the king of the castle. I'm in control. You're the dirty rascal. You may be God, but I want to be king. Well, if you've ever realised how awful it is to treat God like that, you'll also realise that with our actions and with our thoughts, we're saying the same thing that son was. I wish you were dead. I'd be better off without you. Well, if you've realised that this gets us nowhere, and as we turn back to God so sorry for being like this, will he ever accept us back? Well, this son was soon to find out. The whole time, you see, the son was away. His dad had been scanning the horizon, looking to see if there was any sign that his son might have started his journey back home. And when he spots him far off, the dad then speaks by his actions too. He does something that nobody at the time in his position, an older man, respected, would ever have done. He picked up his garments and he ran. Now, you might love running. I don't like it that much, but it's no embarrassment to me if I run. But in those days, if a grown man were to run, everyone would scoff, laugh. It was a disgrace. And yet this father so loved his son that he would take this disgrace in order to open wide his arms and welcome him home and celebrate. My son was lost. And he is now home. Jesus was showing you and me that God loves lost people so much that he would take the greatest disgrace to open wide his arms and accept back people who had even said to him, I wish you were dead. I'm better off without you. And this is great news for you. And for me, that is how much God loves us. He wants you to know it, and he wants us to tell everyone. Who might you tell this week?
We are now going to sing this week's big worship song, and our song this week is by Rend Collective, and it's called I'll Go Anywhere. So everybody up on your feet, see if you can join in the actions, and let's praise God together this morning. I'll go anywhere. long as I'm with you. I'll go anywhere, anywhere you call me to, as long as I'm with you. As long as I'm with you. You're the adventure of a lifetime, Jesus. You take my heart and make it wild. You are the thrill my soul is seeking, Jesus. Your grace is no horizon line. Your grace is no horizon line. And I'll go anywhere, anywhere at all, as long as I'm with you. I'll go anywhere, anywhere you call me to, as long as I'm with you. As long as I'm with you. You take me out beyond the waves, Lord Jesus. You are the captain of my soul. There is no map for where your wild heart takes us. We're running into the unknown. We're running into the unknown. And I'll go anywhere, anywhere at all, as long as I'm with you. I'll go anywhere, anywhere you call me to, as long as I'm with you. As long as I'm with you. I'll go anywhere, anywhere at all, as long as I'm with you. I'll go anywhere, anywhere you call me to, as long as I'm with you. As long as I'm with you. We're the young, we're the bold, we're the fearless. We are the strong, we are the brave, we are the dreamers. We are the ones who carry love into the darkness. We are the fire burning inside, nothing can stop us. We are the young, we are the bold, we are the fearless. We are the strong, we are the brave, we are the dreamers. We are the ones who carry love into the darkness. We are the fire burning inside, nothing can stop us. Go anywhere, anywhere at all, as long as I'm with you. I'll go anywhere, anywhere you call me to, as long as I'm with you. As long as I'm with you.
The Prodigal Son is one of my favourite stories in the Bible. Sometimes we do things that hurt, disappoint other people or God. If we're sorry, God forgives us. The Bible says he remembers our sin no more. We are all like the prodigal son. I want to show you an illustration on the iPad. So this is a picture of a prodigal son. And the black squishy lines represent our sin in our lives and the sin in his life. Doesn't matter how big or how small our sin is, it's all seen by God. But it says in the Bible, if we pray to God, he will remember our sin no more. And however big or however small that sin is, he will erase it like nothing. It's all gone. There we go. We are going to make a sorry bin. Think of something you are sorry for, write it or draw it down on a piece of paper, and then screw it up and drop it into our sorry bin. Thank God for sending Jesus so that we can be forgiven. So one example is not sharing with my sweets, shouting at my sister, not listening to our mums or dads, telling lies about my brother. Dear God, please forgive me for what I did. It was wrong and I disobeyed you. Please help me not to do it again. Thank you that by the time I have finished this prayer, there will be no record of my sin. Lord, help me to love you more and more each day. Father God, I pray, Lord, for the kids of Groundbreakers, whether they're at school or whether they're at home, Lord. Bring them back safely again next week so we can learn more about you. Amen. See you next week.